just so many, so much people everywhere, everywhere you look, and it's very overwhelming. Thank you so much for coming, every one of you. It is so great to be here in Denver, in Colorado, with all of you. So much nice people, everyone is so wonderful. Thank you so much. We recognize we are on Indigenous land of Arapaho and Cheyenne. Yes, this is real hope. This is what we are seeing right now. This is the hope, the people. This is a movement with millions upon millions of people telling world leaders to act on the science, and we are demanding a safe future for everyone. And that is not something you can continue to ignore. It is we young people and future generations who are going to suffer the most from the climate and ecological crisis. It should not be up to us to take the responsibility, but since the leaders are behaving like children, then we have no other choice. The older generations are failing us, and the political leaders are failing us. But we will be watching and holding them accountable. We will make sure they will not get away with continuing like now. Because we, as young people, are tired of constantly being betrayed by those who are supposed to work for our greater good. We are here because we care about the future, about what we one day will leave after us. And the political leaders can't seem to think beyond the next election, and that needs to come to an end. Yeah. For well over a year, young people from all around the world have been striking from school every Friday, demanding world leaders to take this responsibility and to unite behind the science. They have not done that. The people in power continue to ignore us and to ignore the current best available science. How dare they? How dare they leave this mess for their own children to clean up and solve? How dare they pretend that they are doing enough when the politics needed are still nowhere in sight? How dare they ignore the countless of people all around the world who are suffering and dying today because of the climate and ecological crisis and the ecosystems that are being destroyed. They are indeed not mature enough to tell it like it is, so we will do it for them. We still have this in our own hands, but to do our best is no longer good enough. We all need to do the seemingly impossible. We didn't start school striking because we wanted to. We didn't do it because we wanted to gain attention or because it was fun. We did it because someone needs to do something. And that someone could be me, it could be you, or anyone in this crowd. You don't have to wait for someone else to do something. No one is too small to make a difference. Never forget that. And we will go on every Friday for as long as it takes. The next big global strike is November 29th. And we must prepare ourselves to go on for a very long time, unfortunately. But that will not stop us. We are rising and we will not back down. We will not beg the people in power to care and to act, because they have ignored us in the past and they will ignore us again. We will instead tell them that if they won't do it, then we will. The world is waking up, and we are the change. And change is coming whether you like it or not. Thank you once again so much. And continue the fight. Don't give up.